everybody, it's Dr. Joe, and today we're going to talk about neuromuscular stimulators, and the folks at Shophysio sent me their Neurodyn II by Ibramed, so let's get started.
Disclaimer alert! Disclaimer alert!
So what I really like about the Neurodyn II neuromuscular stimulator is it has three different settings to it. It's got the traditional TENS, which is for pain relief. It has a Russian current, which is really getting that muscle contraction for muscle retraining and help getting that strength back. And then it also has an FES, which is the functional electrical stimulation, which really helps that muscle functionally. So like, let's say maybe you have foot drop and you're really trying to get that dorsiflexion, you can use the FES or the functional electrical stimulation to help pull it up while you're walking, or it simulates help pulling it up while you're walking. So it's really cool that it has these three different settings. It also has four different channels that you can use, and you can use them independently, which is really cool because this is a professional unit, and so when you're in the clinic, maybe more than one person wants to use it. So since the channels are used independently, that's a really great component to have when you're in a clinic. So again, with this being professional use, you still might want to watch this video because you want to learn about the functions that it uses. So if it's something that you think will help you, you can go ask your therapist or your healthcare professional and see if it's right for you. And so I really like these professional units because sometimes the handheld units are great that you can get for home use, but if you really want to get that strong muscle contraction where you're retraining and you have somebody that's a professional healthcare provider helping you do that, these really help get that strong current in there to help you going. So the Russian current is really one of my favorites. It's no fun at all. I mean, you want maximum contraction where it's almost unbearable, but it really helps retrain that muscle. And so what I like about this specific unit is it's really user-friendly. It's easy to use. If you're in the clinic, you don't want to have to sit there and set up a whole bunch of different things. So it's got where you can program some protocols in there for yourself. So let's say I want to be able to activate that anterior tibialis that I use the same settings every time. You can plug that in once into your user program and then it's there for you every time. So it just makes it more efficient in the clinic where you don't have to set stuff up every single time. But if you want to, since everybody's a little bit different, you can do that each time as well. So what I wanna do is just show you a little bit about each one and the parameters you can use with them, because some of them do have different wavelengths. Again, the Russian current versus the functional electrical stimulation, when you're doing the FES, you really want just enough current to be able to accomplish what you're trying to do. Or like, let's say it's on my wrist extensors. I'm trying to do this because my muscles are really weak and I just can't lift it up. I don't want it to be so strong where it's just hurting and uncomfortable and it's coming up and just making that muscle contract so much. I'd use that functional electrical stimulation where it's just enough to get it up and I can practice that movement while it's coming up. Versus if I really didn't have much at all and I really did just want to strengthen that muscle, I'd use that Russian current where I'm really trying to get a strong contraction. And a lot of times it's really great on your quad after a knee surgery because like a total knee replacement or something like an ACL reconstruction, sometimes your quad just goes, I'm not doing anything anymore. And that Russian current is a great way to help get that muscle contracting again so you have a better recovery in the long run. So let me put everything together and show you how it works. So as you can see here, what's really cool about the unit is with the different channels, the four different channels, there's four different colors. And so again, this is for clinical use, for professional use. And if you've ever been in the clinic and you're sharing a unit with somebody, you know that having it color coded makes it super easy, because if someone's using channel one, they'll know what color it is. If someone wants to use channel three, they know what color it is. And that really does make a pretty big difference. So I'm gonna go ahead and turn it on. And so when it first comes on, the Ibramed logo shows up and then it says the Neurodyn II. And so when you set up your parameters, it has all the ways to set it up here. I'm not going to go into too much detail about the different parameters, because since this is for professional use, the clinician should know which one works best for them, which one works best for their patients, depending on what the injury is and everything like that. But I'll briefly kind of go over the different selections that you can pick and the modes and things like that. So the first thing is just the current that you want. So you can use your TENS, you can use your FES, or you can use your Russian current. And then, so again, you can see that there's not a whole lot of buttons that you have to press, so it makes it super easy where you're just doing the select up and down, and then you're doing the set, picking the ones once you select it. So you can then do your timer, which it goes from 1 to 60 minutes. And so that's nice. Usually in most of the electrical stimulation settings, I would say 15 minutes at the most. If you're doing like a Russian current, probably just 10 minutes because you're contracting that muscle so much. You probably don't want anything longer than that. If you're doing a TENS, you might want it a little bit longer. But again, in the clinical setting, you know, this is just a part of the therapy. That's not the whole therapy. So maybe 15 to 20 minutes at the most. But it does have the option to go higher if you want to. It also has the manual stimulation. So you can, this is where if you want channel one, maybe for like a TENS, and then channel two for the TENS, so you're crossing it, you can independently increase the intensity between the two, which is nice because if I am just putting my unit here and here, the channels, I might want the one on the inside a little bit stronger this way versus that way. So it's just nice to be able to use them kind of independently. And then you've also got, for if you're using like the Russian current, you can ramp up and ramp down. It has the settings for that, which is nice because if you've ever had it on you, and I've had it on me before, you want a little bit of a ramp up so you know when it's starting to happen, because you want that contraction to be strong. You want, I always tell my patients, tell me when it's high enough where you can't tolerate it anymore, and then usually go up about one or two after that, which is mean, but usually you want that strong contraction, but you want that ramp up so they know it's coming, so it doesn't just come on nice and strong. And then you can do the same ramping it down as well. So that's a nice component of those two. And then you can just set all these parameters depending on if you're doing the TENS, the Russian current, or the FES. And then with the TENS, you can also do, if you want just a normal conventional, which is the ramping nice and slow up down, or you can do the burst cycle, which it changes it up a little bit so your body doesn't adjust to the current and kind of adapt to it. So all those settings are really nice. And again, they change depending on what you're using it for, the patient you're using it for, the type of injury, and things like that. So make sure and do your research and find out the best parameters for what you're going to use. So I'm really quickly just going to show you kind of on my wrist extensors so you can see it. So I'm just going to use one channel for that. And I'm going to use actually the functional setting, because what's nice about that is it's going to be just enough where it's going to pull it up, but not so much where I can't tolerate it. And so that's what I think is probably going to be the best one. So I'm just going to do FES there and channel one. So with these, they've got the little pigtail attachments. You just kind of snap it in, make sure they're all the way in there, and then you can kind of go maybe down here and then up here. So you're really wanting to get kind of up top and then in that belly area. So this might even be a little bit too low. I really want on the belly of the muscles right here and here to help get that contraction when I'm going. So once you have the pads placed, you're going to go ahead and then hit the start. And then for channel one, which is on, I'm just going to slowly start taking it up. I can feel just a little bit of tingling now. So I usually tell my patients, you know, I'm going to go fast until you start feeling it. And then once it starts getting to where you're like, yeah, I feel it, then I'm going to start going slower until we can get that contraction. Once I start feeling that pull, I'm going to just going to pull up with it. So as it comes up, I'm going to try and pull up with it. And then when it lets go, I'm going to drop back down as well. And so that's really with functional electrical stimulation, all you're doing, you're trying to functionally move the muscle as well. And so sometimes, depending on what current you're using, you might have to move the pads around a little bit, and that's fine. The clinician should be able to, you know, do that and show you how to do it as needed. So if you're interested in purchasing the Neurodyn II or any of the other products at Shophysio, which are professional use products for things like physical therapy, aesthetics, and athletic training, make sure you can click on the link up there. And don't forget to subscribe by clicking down there. And remember, be safe, have fun, and I hope you feel better soon.